So, you have a science degree and a business degree. Why these two degrees?
Well...
Oh my god, he must think I'm an idiot for getting two degrees. Aw man, he seems like he's a go-getter and he has the utmost confidence. Man, he must think I'm an idiot.
Well, are you going to answer the question?
What was the question again?
Hey man, do you know where the Byward Market is?
It's on...
Aw man, this guy seems cool. He must have a fun life and cool hobbies. I wish I was like him. He seems to have everything together. Why is he even talking to someone like me?
Dude, are you okay? I don't know.
If I could tell you all the times where I had a similar thought process where I hyped up the other person in my head only to get intimidated and look like a fool, it would be longer than the uncut version of the Lord of the Rings trilogy. The uncut version. Jokes aside, when I was younger, I easily got intimidated by other people. I mean, as soon as I saw another person, I instantly thought that they were better than me and didn't have the same petty human problems like I did. I felt shame for having to deal with very human problems like dealing with fear, not having a clear life direction, etc. I thought it was only me who had all these problems and that everyone else had it figured out. And as a result, I naturally got intimidated by other people. But do you want to know the true reason why I got intimidated? It wasn't because I had bigger problems than most people. It wasn't because I had low self-confidence. It wasn't because I didn't have my shit together. The reason I got intimidated by other people was because I didn't see myself and others as humans. Well, that sounds weird. How couldn't I see myself or others as human beings? Well, if I'm being honest, I let my imagination go crazy. I let my imagination convince me that regular human issues were only my problem and that no one else had them. I'm talking about regular human problems like making mistakes, not knowing things, normal insecurities, etc. Even when it came to using the bathroom, I had shame because it seemed only a person like me could use the washroom for dirty things. I know. Back then, I was a mess. And if I'm being honest, my imagination didn't stop there. I not only thought less of myself, but I also thought others were better than being human. Wait, what does being better than human even mean? Well, I thought other people didn't have regular human problems and were perfect in some weird way. This made it hard for my social life as I never felt like I was valuable enough to be a part of someone else's life. Mind you, I was able to make friends here and there. This was because of people wanting to be my friend. However, when I wanted to seek out new friends on my own initiative, I failed miserably. So how can you ensure you don't make the same mistake as me and stop being intimidated by other people? Well, to stop being intimidated by other people, you have to start consciously practicing this one habit. And when I mean practice every moment you interact with another human being. I don't care if it's the president, a CEO, a boss, or your local Starbucks barista. You practice this habit every moment you get a chance. So, what is this habit I speak of? It's to humanize yourself and everyone. I know this answer sounds lame, but it's true. The problem with intimidation is that we think less of ourselves and/or think too highly of others. So with humanizing yourself and others, you realize that everyone has the same petty human problems. Everyone has to deal with fear, emotions, conflict, setbacks, etc. And just in case I'm not being clear, think of humanizing others like this. Everyone has to take a crap. Even that cute girl you've been crushing on, she uses the washroom to take a crap. So the next time you meet someone new and you start getting intimidated, take a step back and just start imagining that person taking a crap in the washroom, where they're grunting and all. Okay, maybe that's a little too graphic. But you get the point. You humanize yourself and others by realizing that we're all humans with the same petty human problems. About 2,000 years ago, Epictetus, the great Roman Stoic, said something similar where if you start getting intimidated by another person, just start imagining them having sex where they're grunting and sweating and all. Epictetus was a freak. Anyways, you get the idea. So the next time you start tensing up and feeling intimidated, remember to humanize yourself and others. This will help you in your dating life, social life, and career. By being able to be not intimidated, you'll be able to let your natural self shine, meaning you will attract people who will want to be around you and repel people you were never going to like. Half the battle in life is not getting in your own way. Anyways, let's stop the inspirational talk and let's tackle an objection that some of you may have. This seems like a lot of work to remember to humanize yourself and others. Yeah, it is a lot of work, but only in the beginning. And here's the thing, and I learned this the very hard way. We can have bad mental habits where we undervalue ourselves and overvalue others. So it's going to require a lot of work at first. So when you're meeting someone new, maybe that cute girl or that cool dude, you have to humanize yourself and them. And that may require thinking for a few minutes that the other person craps like you and the other 7 billion people on Earth. They have to clean themselves like you and me. The more often you do this, the easier it becomes, and eventually it becomes its own mental habit, where you are naturally not intimidated and are able to express yourself authentically. You have to remember, guys, life is too short not to show your best self. Life has so much to offer, but like I said before, half the battle is not getting in your own way. And trust me, when you're not getting in your own way, you will find great friends and have amazing relationships. You'll also have an amazing love life with memorable experiences. Again, life has so much to offer, so don't let something like being intimidated by others hold you down. I missed out on a lot of opportunities for my social life, love life, and career due to being intimidated. So don't make that mistake. Anyways, let's hop on to the summary.
The reason we get intimidated is because we don't see ourselves and others as human beings. The simplest way to humanize yourself and others is to remind yourself that everyone has to take a crap. Even though it's a lot of work to humanize yourself and others, it gets easier over time.
Alright guys, that's it for today. Thank you again for watching. Please don't forget to like this video, comment, subscribe to my channel, subscribe to my email list, and guys, remember, you're not just any type of nerd. You're a charismatic nerd.